We are standing at the beginning part of where all of this happened. The BMW is actually just several blocks away, and you can see that it has a shattered window. But you also found a really compelling element of how all of this went down. You spoke with someone who saw a shooting victim.
Yeah, I mean, this young man is a first-year student at Santa Barbara City College. He's 19 years old, came from Hawaii. He said he was in his room. He could hear shots going off. And suddenly he went downstairs, he heard one barrage of shots, and then he heard another. And then he went down to the scene and suddenly saw something he could not believe his eyes. Can you tell me, what did you see?
I was leaving the fraternity right there. Okay. And I heard the gunshots, and I recognized the sound of a gun. I've shot a gun before. So I waited, and then I heard more gunshots. And then after about like 30 seconds, I came around the corner right here.
So you're there at the fraternity.
Yeah.
You're there, you're just down the street, and mm-hmm. you come around the corner after hearing gunshots, and what'd you see?
Okay, so I came up, and basically, there was a young girl laying right here, and I could just tell immediately that she was gone. I saw a gunshot wound to her abdomen, and like on her side, and also one to her head. So you could tell she wasn't bleeding anymore, so she was gone. There was another girl right here.
My God, there were more than one.
There was three girls, yeah.
Three girls.
There was a girl right here, and she was really, really struggling. You could tell she was just barely able to move her eyes and just moving her arms slightly. And then there was another girl right here, and she was kind of like laying down, crouched. She was still conscious. She was talking. She immediately got on the phone with her mother and was telling her mother about how much she loved her, and she wasn't sure that she was gonna make it.
Oh my God.
And then probably took about a minute or two, and the one right here passed away. And then
what were you doing this whole time as you're looking at this terribly grisly scene?
I was complete shock. I walked up and about three other people came from this angle. I didn't realize that this was real life at all.
Were you trying to talk to them? Did they say anything to you? Did you hear?
Yeah, them? I was talking to the one on the phone because I could tell. She said that she got shot in the kidney, and she got. I could see that she had shots to her arm, so I could tell that she was probably gonna make it. So I was telling her that she was gonna be okay. I spoke to her mother real quick. I told her mother that she was probably gonna make it. We saw a police officer right down there by Freebirds, so we brought him over here immediately. And he held her and was holding her wounds to stop the bleeding. And then I asked the police officer if we were safe staying here, just because of that there was a person driving around shooting people. And he said that that we were okay. But then literally like 20 seconds after that, we heard the next shots at the market over there. And then that's when he basically yelled at everyone and told them to run indoors. And then I ran back to the fraternity, and I like ran down the street and told everyone to go indoors, and people were just locked themselves in.
I noticed that your voice is still shaking.
Yeah.
You're still trying to process all of this.
Yeah, it was a huge shock last night. I really, wasn't really able to sleep at all, and it was heartbreaking that something would happen in our community like this.
And that 19-year-old City College student, I mean, he was completely shaken up. He said he stayed up all night long trying to get more details as to what happened. But imagine, he's there and he did what he could. He tried to help the one victim that he said was still alive, but he also witnessed two victims die. John.